Here we have an overview of a containerized Actix microservice that will eventually be deployed to AWS. You can see a common structure here that's similar to many projects I work on. I have a makefile, I have a Dockerfile, I have a cargo.2ml file, and I also have a lib and a main.rs. Let's go ahead and dive into it. So here we have this Rust tutorial that I've been hooking up here that's in the notes that you can link to. And we see that it says containerized active microservice. I have a link to the project. And then let's look at the Dockerfile. So this Dockerfile uses Rust as a builder. So what happens is that this environment is able to use all of the developer resources you care about, but then it pushes it into a new container. So this is a nice slick way to build a very tiny container. And once it is able to be pushed into this new container, we expose 8080 and we set up an entry point that says web Docker. Also, we have a cargo.2ml file that has our dependencies. There's a random and Actix web here. There's a lib.rs here, and there's not a lot going on. We just have a random fruit that's delivered via this function. And again, this is a public function, so it can be used in main. And then the main is quite simple. It looks a lot like, let's say, a Flask or maybe a fast API app. I import some dependencies here, and then I go through and I use my library, and then I go through and I set up each of these entry points. So I have a slash, I have fruit, get health, get version. And then in the main here, we go through and we register all those services. So pretty straightforward process. And then finally, when we deploy to App Runner, you'll see here, it's actually, this is a picture of the running service. And then finally, when you want to build this yourself, if you go to this project, you just cd into web Docker, and you can either use the makefile or you can just run docker build -t fruit and then docker run, and it'll run this. Once you push it then to ECR, you can tell App Runner to do an auto deploy. So this is one of the key takeaways that's nice about ECR, is that once you push a container there and you have App Runner registered, it's ready to auto deploy. All right, let's go ahead and see this in action.
We can go to this Docker file and we can do that. And then instead of here, if I refresh, we got a make file. There we go. So I'm going to say make format. What happens? It's going to compile it, run it, and I should see something show up to standard out. And I should also be able to preview this thing, which would be pretty slick. Okay, let's open up in the browser. Let's look here too. Look, running the service. See, that's my message down here. Right, so you can put prints inside of here and see what's going on with Actix. And look, hello world, random fruit. We see that thing. And then if I want to go to, what is it, fruit or something like that? Orange, right? So we can see like, hey, it works, not bad. Right, I have a random fruit service. Right? Pineapple, grapes, orange, watermelon, mango, right? And look, it's printing them out here. So nice. Copy Rust up. I mean, this shows you how ridiculously awesome Rust is. Like, I just run a command and it just puts everything on there. The only other thing I need to do is clone this repo. So it's going to compile, or it's going to install Rust real quick. And then I'm going to need to go over here, and I'm going to need to clone this. I'm going to clone as HTTPS because I don't want to push anything. I just want to clone it and build a container. There we go. So we're going to do this. We're going to store this variable, and I'm going to source cargo, and we're good to go. So now all I have to do is say git clone this one. Now I just cd into this, and I cd into web Docker, and then I just say inside of web Docker, here. All I need to do is look at this makefile here, and basically just tweak the commands a little bit. So what I'm going to do is, if we go back to it, to this Actix thing here, check this out. I'm going to say view push commands, and I'm going to auth first. So we're going to auth. There we go. And then I'm going to go to the next one. I'm going to say docker build Actix. Now this is just going to tag it with the name of this ECR so that I can actually push it there. And let's just let this thing go. And this is why I think it is good to have a nice beefy machine, you know, when you're working with this. So it's going to do what I just did in CodeSpaces, but it's going to put it inside of Cloud9. So I think this really shows as well what's cooking. So let's go ahead and get this thing cooking, install web Docker crates. There we go. Updating crates.io. And let's let this thing finish. Pretty exciting. Because where I see this headed is I think I am going to get App Runner working properly. Okay, we got all that cooking. And let's go here. So now we're going to push this ridiculously small container, not like gigs and gigs and gigs. It's under 100 megabytes. Look at this, ridiculous, right? So if we say Docker image ls, 94 megabytes, what is going on? And now it's trivial to deploy this. All I have to do is I go to App Runner and I say, hey, let's go. Let's build another service. I'm going to use container registry and we're going to go here and we're going to find Actix. And we're going to say manual. You could do automatic, because right, every time I push a new binary, you could, you know, that inside of that container, but let's just do manual to start with. We're going to use existing service and we're going to say next. We're going to call this Rust Actix here. And let's go. Let's see what happens. Let's check this out. I'm pretty confident this is going to work. And what's awesome about this is it shows why many people should seriously consider using Rust for microservices, right? Because we know that the binary is just massively small. Successfully routed incoming traffic, deployed with ID. How about now? There we go. Look at this. Whoa. I have to admit, I'm impressed with myself. So we can go here and we can say fruit, apple. Check this out. Look at this. Awesome, 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 awesome. Super high performance out here. And if we do health, we got a health check here as well. If we go to the main page, we've got this. So in my opinion, this is a world beater right here, is Actix. And I'm going to take a little screenshot of this thing and let people play around with it a little bit. But really, really slick stuff here. I think I'm going to call it a day. This is a massive victory.